And I want to say that on my honor as a Christian, on my honor as a father, and on the oath of my office as a Senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, I am telling you the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. I have never been a coward.
That was how the Kogi-born senator started the speech at the Senate briefing hall. Senator Dino Malai denied using abusive words during the closed-door section. He said the news that the public was fed with was fabricated by Senator Oluremi Tinubu and her husband.
Because they are yet to heal from the wound of defeat of the election of the Senate president, and because of my key role in this exercise, where she and her husband called me separately to appeal to me to back off Saraki, and I say I will not back off Saraki. I will continue to support Saraki. He's my brother, he's my friend, and I will continue to support him, and this will not change today, it will not change tomorrow, it will not change in these 4 years of our stay in the Senate.
The embattled senator also denied the reported plot to impeach the president. He explained that the issue was never discussed. He went further to talk tough, insisting that everyone should be allowed to actualize his or her political ambition.
Every human being can have ambition. It is not a crime to be ambitious. Saraki had the ambition of becoming a Senate president, and God endorsed it. President Muhammadu Buhari himself is an ambitious person. That's why he contested for the presidency 4 times before God answered him. I am an ambitious person. I even want to be the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria very soon. So it is not a crime to be ambitious. So if you go through the papers today, there's been a lot of misinformation, a lot of lies, a lot of blackmail, planted stories, just to disparage the person and personality of Dino Melaye.
With this outburst by the pro-Saraki senator, political watchers believed that the stage is now set for another round of controversy, not only in the Senate, but the All Progressive Congress. Uche Adaeze, ITV News, Abuja.